and welcome to Ease the Spirit Ministries of Hope. I'm Reverend Morgan Alexander, and every month here at Ease the Spirit, we celebrate a God-given spiritual power. And the month of August, that power is will. The disciple that represents that power is Matthew, and the color for the month is gray. We start every service on Sunday with a short meditation. So if you would like to relax and join us for the meditation, just make yourself comfortable. And if you want to close your eyes, feel free to do so. We're going to start off by taking three cleansing breaths. The first two we'll hold for a count of three. The last one we will hold for a count of five. So, inhale. One, two, three. And exhale. Inhale. One, two, three. And exhale. And this one we'll hold for a count of five. And when you exhale, let go of any stress, any tension, any anxiety, anything negative that has happened in the past week. So inhale, one, two, three, four, five, and exhale deeply. Let go of all that stress and relax. Gratitude today. How very, very, very grateful we are to be here. How very, very, very grateful we are for our guest speaker today. How thankful, Lord, we are that you have put so many wonderful things in our life. And let's just think about that. Take a moment to think of the things that you are grateful for. I am grateful for my health. I am grateful for my health. I am most direct gifts of God, known as unexpected pleasures.
Just take a moment and soak in what the Reverend Morgan just said. I am grateful. I am grateful. And so this is our time to invoke the Holy Spirit. You know that the Holy Spirit is stirring in you now. It is moving through every fiber of your being. You know that the Holy Spirit is the advocate. They come to bring all things into remembrance. And as we remember who and whose we are, children of the Most High, created in God's image and likeness, we give thanks for that Holy Spirit. What I really want you to do right now is to take something that you have been praying about or working on, and I want you to hold it in your mind right now, because realize that you are creating within yourself to be a sanctuary. And because you're creating within yourself to be that sanctuary, that means that you can place it on the altar. So whether you're praying over someone, whether you're praying over a project that you're working on, whether you're praying for health, wealth, hold it in your mind right now. And I say, Heavenly Father, blessed Holy Spirit, we give you the honor, we give you the praise, we give you the reverence, we give you the glory. As we look into the landscape, which is the world that you created, we see your magnificence. We see your orderly divine knowledge as the sun rises and sets. We see it when we look at the stars at night. We see it when we look at the beautiful flowers and butterflies and all of the beauty of nature. And so we give you reverence today. We also see your abundance, Father, because we know that if we sat on our front porch and tried to count the blades of grass, we lose count. We know that if we were to go on the beach and just scoop up one hand of sand, that the grains would be too numerous for us to count. And so we recognize you, Heavenly Father. We recognize you as love, because your gravity that holds the entire universe in place and makes it harmoniously rotate is your love. And that love is within us because we know we are powerfully and wonderfully made. We recognize you as life in our body, and every part of your body is bursting with radiant energy. We recognize you as divine substance, Heavenly Father. And so we know you are the gift and the giver, the substance and the supply. We recognize you as power. And because you have created us in our image and likeness, you gave us the power to speak over the circumstances in our life and say, peace be still. You gave us the power to decree a thing, and it will not return to us void. And so right now, Heavenly Father, we give you the honor and praise, and we give gratitude. We're grateful for everything that you've done. We're grateful for everything that you will do, but we're exceptionally grateful for this moment of now, because in this moment we can declare that there is absolutely nothing we can ask for that you haven't already provided. Right now I'm going to pray this prayer, and this is a very well-used, very well-known prayer. It is Psalms 23. And whatever you are placing on the altar, I want you to place it there as we do this affirmative prayer. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Know that you're not wanting for anything, because whatever it is that God has placed on your heart, whatever divine idea is fully clothed with everything that's needed to bring it into manifestation. And so, Heavenly Father, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. For you make me to lie down in green pastures of peace, and you lead me beside the still waters. Heavenly Father, you restore my soul. Is it someone within the sound of my voice that's looking for peace today? I want you to know that he restores your soul and leads you beside still waters of peace. And so we may be going through something. We may be walking through some valley right now, but you need to know that if you're going through the valley, you have access to the mountaintop. And so, yea, though I walk through some valleys, Father, I might be walking through some valleys of pain and hurt. I might be walking through some valleys of death. I might be walking through some valleys of debt. I might be walking through some valleys of an unsettled spirit. I might be walking through a valley of worry about my child. I might be walking through a valley where there's not peace in the home.
But I know that you are with me, and so that means that whatever that thing is that you have placed on the altar, it's already done. I want you to claim it for yourself today. It is already done. I want you to claim it for yourself today. It is already done. And so realize that God prepares a table for you, even in the midst of your enemies. Now, we have all kinds of enemies, and sometimes your greatest enemy is the thoughts running through your own mind. And so ask yourself, what are the thoughts? Heavenly Father, if I'm holding on to thoughts of doubt, of fear, of lack, of limitation, I say take it from me right now. I give thanks that you prepare a table for me even in the midst of those thoughts. And I give thanks, Father, because you are anointing my head with love. And I give thanks that my cup runs over. And so it is. I am going to call Jordan up. He's going to help us today to continue with this anointing, this in the place. I want you to play for us, James, this day.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
He's truly worthy to be praised. This day, our day,
hey, we're not to start that
bread. That's all right. That's all right. It's okay. It's all right. We usually hear this song at weddings, but you know, it's a song of meditation. It's a prayer, and you're asking God to give you this day, this joy, this love, whatever it is that you need today. So appropriate after the prayer. God bless you. God bless you.
Okay.
Yes, we do.
Okay, we celebrate and give thanks for the many blessings every Sunday beginning at 10:45 a.m. here at 2728 Lancashire Road in Cleveland Heights, Ohio. We would love for you to bless us with your presence. That's how I really love it. I love to see you here. You can, however, also join us online via Zoom or on Facebook. Please join us in holy fellowship as we practice the presence of the Holy Spirit while practicing appropriate social safety measures. Divine wisdom and love dictates that we make personal protection equipment available. And I want to say right now that if you want to take a few extra masks, we do have them available. You're free to do that. Anything that you see on the table, we have sanitizers. We want to be safe and that we employ social distancing during our services. Now, I gotta talk about this group because I love this group. This is my EOS Spiritual Awakening group. And I'm gonna tell you something. I do this every Sunday. I go on and on about this group. We meet every Saturday at 9 a.m. And it is such a blessing as we talk about our spiritual journey. Right now, we're working with the Jesus Trilogy, and we're applying the new thought principles that we know to it, and we're just learning. We're dealing right now with Wheel. This is the month of August, and we celebrate the spiritual attribute of Wheel here at Ease of Spirit. So happen with this book, we're working with the power of Wheel and Choice. And we're talking about how does that look like in our life, world, and affairs. And so it is a beautiful group. It starts your Saturday out beautifully. And I know that for each and every one of the people that join the Spiritual Awakening group, they have beautiful Saturdays because it just sets it off. And I want to give honor to that group. That's like my favorite group. It really is. And let me give you a couple of other announcements. The Reverend Morgan. Morgan, please stand up. Now, you know that we always deal with transition and we always deal with change and we deal with loss. Reverend Morgan has a wonderful program that she's doing. It is the Puzzle Piece Ministry. It is her brainchild. And right now, if you're dealing with a loss, it's not always about the transition of a loved one, although we all have done that. We've all gone through that. But it could be the loss of a job. It could be the ending of a relationship. Sometimes we have transitions that we are looking forward to as something good, but you're letting go something else that maybe serves you well at some point in time. Whatever it is, you can come and you can work with her. Now you got to talk to her because it is a program, she keeps telling us. And so you got to talk to her about how you fit in. But we have grief counseling and recovery services available. So if you need someone to counsel you with grief, me and my husband will gladly do it. Reverend Morgan will do it. Or you can join the classes or look forward to some of the workshops that's forthcoming. And we have our Bible studies, which take place on Thursday. Thursday from 4 to 6, the Reverend James does an in-person Bible study, and they are really enjoying it. It's going very well. Then I follow from 7 to 8:30 with an online Bible study. So you can go to our business page. There are always Zoom links. I always send the Zoom links out, but they never change. Once you use the Zoom link, you can really use it over and over again. I only put it out over and over again for convenience sake. And you can go past that announcement. And so visit us at Ease of Spirit Ministries of Ministries.org. And there you will find a lot of beautiful writings. There is a friend of mine that is in Tennessee. Her name is Satoria Lindsay. She has a whole selection of the 12 powers you can read there. Reverend Morgan will ask you, you know, did Jesus grieve? And she has some beautiful articles. I have articles. And if you happen to be a writer and you want to add to that ministry, I'm open and receptive, so let me know. You can visit us also on YouTube and like and share our videos. We are a new ministry. We're 2 years old, and we're trying to grow in so many different levels. So we appreciate whatever way you support us. Like and subscribe us on Facebook and YouTube. Now, the sweet hour of prayer, Reverend Dorothy, can you just stand up a second so they can see who you are? It's a power play. The sweet hour of prayer, every Sunday at 8 p.m. I am usually there, soaking in that sweet hour of prayer. So if you are interested in prayer, you're interested in learning about praying, you're interested in how do I pray, why am I praying amiss? Sometimes it seems like the prayers aren't being answered. Then I invite you to join the Reverend Dorothy Peterson for her sweet hour of prayer. And her ministry is the Divine Way Ministries. And so I appreciate the Reverend Dorothy and that ends our announcements. Now, I got to tell you about this young lady. God has blessed us today. Little Aaliyah, we're getting our music prepared. She's not little anymore. I used to teach her Sunday school. She is going to bless us with a praise dance. And so I'm so grateful. While we're getting your music together, tell them about your nonprofit suite.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
My name is Aaliyah Ali, and I'm 15 years old. And about a few years ago, I created a nonprofit called Green Light Grow, which raises awareness in plastic reduction. And we have coordinated cleanups around Cleveland. We go around making the neighborhood cleaner so that, you know, my little sister and her friends can grow up in a clean neighborhood. We recently had the opportunity to be featured on News Channel 5, and I'm just thankful to God. Thank you for all the opportunities that you came out with. I no complaints here. And, you know, Green Light Grow isn't this big gesture, it's a lifestyle. You know, if you see trash on the street, you can pick it up and throw it away. And I know it may not seem like it makes a big difference, but it does, and it does help our world so that we can work towards a more sustainable future. Thank you.
Sometimes it feels
Before I announce our guest speaker, I do want to say to each and every one that we are having fellowship downstairs after the service. We're trying to make arrangements, I hope we do, so that if you want to take them, I know that this is difficult times right now. If you want to take your food with you, that's fine, and I do understand that. And so we're trying to make arrangements for takeout. And so I invite you also, though, to fellowship with us. I would love to have you fellowship. And so I get to announce this beautiful, beautiful guest speaker. I just want to read a little bit. So proud that Shirley, the Reverend Shirley, get it right, the Reverend Shirley, is here to give and deliver. She's newly ordained, but you know the true ordination comes from God.
Amen.
So she's newly ordained by man. She's been anointed and ordained for a very long time.
Amen.
Reverend Shirley is a Cleveland area certified interspiritual compassionate counselor and minister, founder of Sands Sacred Circle. For more, that's good. For more than 30 years, she has lived an engaged spiritual life as a speaker, facilitator, a writer, and a workshop and retreat leader. Reverend Shirley is a recent graduate of One Spirit Learning Alliance, where she was ordained as an interfaith, interspiritual minister. And praise God. I want to read her quote. Let me see if I can get this right. She has this quote, and I really think it's beautiful. Sometimes it takes a desert before we let go and let God take the wheel and bring us through those dry spells so that we can be healed. It's not by might and not by our own power, but by the Spirit of the loving God that we are nourished and fulfilled in loving divine will. Sometimes relief is just a prayer. And so I want you guys to stand up. I want you to get on your feet. I want you to put your hands together and welcome the beautiful, the dynamic, Reverend Shirley Nelson.
Tuned up. I just want to say hello.
Hello.
Hi. All of my friends from the Living Truth Center and my family, my part of my family's here, these three people right here in the front, and so many faces that I haven't seen for a while. Miss Carol. Gosh, and now the names are leaving me. But you. But I'm so happy to be here, and I'm so grateful to Reverend Andrea and Reverend James for inviting me here today. And the song that they are going to play is Sometimes a Prayer Will Do.
Thank you.
close your eyes and listen to the words and let this song minister to you.
Sometimes we stumble. Sometimes we even fall. And we can't find a friend.
Sometimes a prayer will do. Before I get started, I want to thank Aaliyah, the beautiful dancer, Jordan,
our vocalists, neither of them in the room right now, but they're young people, and it's so beautiful when you see young people in their ministry.
Yes.
Offering their gifts to us. I want to thank Reverend Morgan, Reverend Andrea, for getting us off to such a beautiful start. I almost feel like we can go home because they've already given us so much. And I was forgetting names, but I just want to say Teddy, my buddy. Hello. Sometimes a prayer will do. And as that song indicated, sometimes we find ourselves reaching and not able to find anyone there to help us. But we know that Spirit is always there. And today I want to talk to you about prayer, and I want to talk to you about divine will and how the two intersect. Now, when we talk about prayer, prayer has a way of getting into your spirit, sort of like water gets into the crevices. You don't really know when it's working or how it's working. You just have to do it. And there's so many ways for us to pray. So many ways. I find that I feel my prayers that are most effective is when I'm doing this. Walking and talking back and forth. Walking and talking back and forth. But I've always found that prayer does not always have to be words. Prayer can be silence.
Yes.
And you can go into your space, in your secret space, in your home, in your living room, and you can just sit and be silent. And whatever it is in your spirit that wants an answer, that needs some comforting, that needs to be resolved, you are connected to Spirit. And that prayer will be heard. That prayer will be heard. So never get caught up in the words. Never get caught up in thinking that you gotta have it the right way, say it the right way. It's your intention. So sit or stand or walk and be silent and allow that prayer to be enough. Sometimes we pray with a moan or a groan or a guttural cry. Sometimes it comes from a place way deep inside of us, and it might be pretty ugly, but that's okay. Because it's all about the connection, how you connect to Spirit. And if it's a moan or a groan or a guttural cry, that's enough. Just let it come out of you. Let it come out of you. Sometimes your prayer is one word, and that one word is help. You might not be able to say anything more than that because you're hurting so much, or because you're in a situation and all you can do is say help. And behind that help, there may be words like in your spirit, in your mind, God help me with this mortgage.
Come on today.
God help me find a job. Spirit, get that neighbor away from me. They're getting on my nerves. You could have been in a car accident, and you're sitting there, and the car is upside down, and all you can say is help. Help, the one word. And all of you know that you have been in a situation when all you could say is
helped. And that help came. Another way that we can pray, I think I'm gonna take these shoes off.
It's okay.
They're getting on my nerves. Another way that we can pray is what I call a two-word prayer. And that is, thank you.
Yes.
Philosopher, writer, Meister Eckhart says that thank you is the most effective and important prayer that you can utter.
Yes.
And thank you is a prayer, I say those two ways. It could be a prayer saying, thank you, and in your spirit, in your mind, you're going, thank you for such a beautiful day. Thank you for bringing me to Ease of Spirit Ministries. Thank you for providing a roof over my head. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And that's a prayer of praise. And we know that God likes praise. And so if all you do is say thank you and allow the understanding that God hears all the rest, that is enough. And then your thank you may be, thank you for getting me out of this situation. Thank you for bringing good people into my life. Thank you for a lovely day. And then there's another prayer that we're all familiar with. Oh my God. Now, oh my God could be, oh my God, that tree just came down on my house. Oh my God, you didn't do that for me, did you really? Oh my God, how many times have you said, oh my God, like sweet Jesus, oh my God, this is so good. Or, oh my God, how are we gonna work this out? So I'm gonna tell you a little story about a time when I had to use that one word prayer. Now I've had situations in my life, I've been here for a while, and I've had situations. So this particular one is a situation, and it's from years back. I ain't gonna give you nothing recent. But in 1975, I moved from Cleveland, Ohio to Los Angeles, California. And at that time, it was all about a man. So this man comes along, muscles buffed, big old motorcycle, Cadillac. I didn't know him too well. Been dating for probably a few months back at this time. And one day he says to me, you want to go to California? I'm looking at him. I'm thinking about my life. It's kind of boring, cold in Cleveland. I looked at that man and I said, yes! Yes, I want to go to California. And off we went, packed up a car, pulled the motorcycle with us. Against all the better wishes of my parents, my family, my friends, they said that guy is a good for nothing. Couldn't tell me nothing. I was hard-headed. I had a strong will. Couldn't nobody tell me nothing. I'm like, I'm going to California. So we got to California. We'd been there for about 6 months. And I realized, I am in deep poo-poo. I didn't say the real words, but I realized I was in trouble. This man was an abuser. It started with little stuff. Why you wear your hair like that? Why you say things like that? Can't you talk like a black girl? You talk like a white woman. And started with that. Then it went on to attacking my character. Then it went on to cursing, calling me out of my name. Now I'm telling you, we're just 6 months into it. And I'm thinking about, oh boy. And then it went on to threats on my life. And so I was in a situation, and I'm trying to understand how to get out of it. I don't really have any friends yet. I got a few people that I work with that have been nice to me. I have a few relatives there, but we don't really know each other. I met them once or twice. And this is the type of person who was really nice on the outside. But, so other people thought he was the greatest thing. It was very troublesome. I would go to bed at night, balled up in a little, curled up in a little ball, crying, asking for help. You know, show me a way out of this. Help. And as God would have it, my help came through a co-worker. Him and his wife had just gotten married, and they invited me to come live with them. So that was that situation. And I was able to move on, gratefully. Prayer. Prayer. P-R-A-Y-E-R. P for pause.
Come on today.
R for recalibrate. A for ask. I don't mean to point my finger at you, I just can't help it. Y for yield. E for expand. And R for rest. Now, if you don't take anything else home, you just take home this understanding of prayer. P for pause. Sometimes we have to pause. We have to pause and take our breath. We have to pause and see where we are. We have to pause to clear our minds. We have to pause to try to get a new understanding. We can't just keep going, 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 going. And that's why I talked to you about the many different ways in which we can pray. Whether it's silent, whether it's one word, whether it's two words, whether it's three words, it might be a sentence, it might be a paragraph, it might be a book, but I want you to pause. Pause and get a new understanding so you can understand how Spirit wants to minister to you, wants to show you a new way. R. Recalibrate. Now, if you don't know what recalibrate means, I'll give you an example of why it's so much part of how I understand prayer. If you remember the GPS systems when they first came out, I remember about 25 years ago, if you were using a GPS and you went down the wrong road and you had to turn around, it would go, recalibrate, recalibrate, recalibrate. I thought that was the funniest thing. And so I kind of kept it for myself. so that when I find myself in difficult situations and I know I need to turn around, I'll just say to myself, recalibrate, recalibrate, recalibrate. We can always turn things around. And that's the purpose of prayer too, to help you turn things around. The next letter is A, ask. I pray and I have a conversation with God, with spirit, with the higher power, whatever word you want to use. As an interfaith minister, I use them all. But my most go-to name is God and spirit. So when I pray, I typically use the same four questions. Whether I am praying for something that I need to understand better, for something that I want, for something that maybe I need to forgive someone for. But my four questions are, God, how would you have me look at this? What would you have me do? What would you have me say? And to whom? How would you have me look at this? What would you have me do? What would you have me say? And to whom? And sometimes I just go on after that. That's enough. Why is free yield? Surrender. Surrender to the Holy Spirit. Surrender to God. Surrender to Spirit. Not my will, but thy will be done. When we surrender, we are entering that place of divinity. And this is where the intersection of prayer and divine will connect. We are entering that place of divinity, of divine will. And we can all go there. It's not special for any special people. We all have the ability to enter into the essence of divine will. Where divine will differs from your will, your will, your will, and my will, is that it is fused with holiness. Divine will is infused with love, with compassion, with harmony, with wholeness, with healing. It's not to say that my will is not infused with that at times, your will at times. But when you want to connect with divine will, you connect with the intention of embracing all of that goodness, love, grace, harmony, peace, compassion, joy, so that the experience of life becomes more full. And not only are you opening yourself to be accessible to the things of life that can bless you more, but you're also opening yourself to be blessed. A lot of times people think that, me people too, that our will is something to be suppressed, to be pushed down, to be weary of, and that we constantly have to pray so that our will doesn't take over. And a lot of times that shows up as ego. You know, it feels like the ego has gotten control. But Spirit is not asking us to suppress our will. Spirit is just asking us to align our will. Align our will with God's will. Align our will so that we can experience the divinity, so that we can have the experience of divine guidance, divine harmony, divine connection, divine good in our lives. So yield. Not my will, but thy will be done. E is for expand. Excuse me. There was a book out, Increase My Territory. Yes. Tell me again.
Enlarge my territory.
Yes. And so as you pray that your heart opens, your mind opens. You open up to expand your territory. Not only the inner territory, but the outer. You want the, well, it's not so much that you want, but as the things on the inside change in terms of you reconciling your spirit with God's divine will, the things on the outside will change also. And your territory will expand. And your heart will expand. And your spirit will more easily connect and touch with others. And you'll be even more able to help others. And others will help you. And we can all use some help. Expand my territory. And the last letter is R. Rest. Rest. Relax, rejuvenate, refresh. When you align with divine will, you will automatically find yourself at rest because you are no longer efforting. You are allowing Spirit to work through you. And when Spirit is working through you, you can relax. Because you're not in charge. You're not in control anymore. But that's a willingness. That is a willingness on your part to let go and let God and relax and trust and be in the spirit of grace, knowing that God's got your back. And as you're in this state of divine will, allow it to be more and more a part of your life. You might find, you may not feel that great at times because it's new territory. It's new territory. And in this territory, you're being asked to wait. And so all you can see when you're in that space is the first step. You can't see the whole staircase. And so you find your place in what I call I don't know land. I don't know where God is taking me. I'm just trusting. I can't see everything. But God said he would carry me. And so you're in that place of I don't know land. You may have had an experience during this pandemic of having some kind of revelation come to you through God that you need to do things differently. You need to start your own business. You don't want to go back to that 9-to-5. You need to be still and stop running around and just try to understand. But you may go ahead and start that business. You may go ahead and move to California. In your spirit, you understand that this is God speaking to you. But some people might say, how do you know? Why are you doing that? I don't get it. You can't pay attention to those people.
Absolutely not.
You got to do what God is telling you to do. And right now, we're pretty much all living in I don't know land with this pandemic. And of course, we've had a pandemic of a significant kind in terms of the health issues that we're dealing with. And we're also dealing with that pandemic of racism. And during this pandemic, we're asking questions. You know, we thought 3 months ago it was gonna end. We got the vaccines. And then we figure, oh, it's all gonna be good now. And now here we are, realizing once again, we are a nation divided. And because of that, we really have not been able to move forward. And so it keeps us in this I don't know land. Wow, when's it gonna stop? When are we gonna be able to go back to normal? When can we get rid of these masks? But I tell you, there are worse things than masks. And so we do what we have to do. And we are grateful for the good that we can see in this moment. Just the first staircase, the first step, we're grateful for that. Step back up here. So as I began to wrap things up, I just want to remind you that divine will is pure spiritual energy that comes from the higher dimensions, calling it to you creates an enormous infusion of spiritual energy into your life that awakens new consciousness, realizations, and revelations. I invite you to consider ways in which you can begin to employ, embrace, bring forward into your life that divine connection. Spiritual practice is a way to start moving closer to God, whatever your spiritual practice is. But please consider prayer as your superpower to keep you in that divine connection, which could lead to a divine calling and divine action. Stay in the divine will of God for divine guidance. Remember to pause, recalibrate, ask the right questions, yield,
expand your territory, and then relax. I close with this statement. I will lift up mine eyes unto the hills, from whence cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord, which made heaven and earth. I am lifting up my whole thought to the inflow of divine strength and wisdom. And I believe that today and tomorrow and every day, I am in silent partnership with God, the living Spirit Almighty. I believe the Spirit goes before me and prepares the way. I believe every doorway is open, that new opportunities are presenting themselves, new ideas are coming into mind. I am meeting new situations. My whole experience is increasing in love, in friendship, and in activity. I expect to be successful. I anticipate being prosperous. And I gladly share everything that I have with others, realizing that in this great game of life, I am not only one with God, but with all people. And so it is.
Yes.
That was gorgeous. That was just gorgeous. James, I want you to put on The Impossible Dream. The Reverend Dorothy is going to sing The Impossible Dream. Our benediction is going to be The Secret Place, which is going to be sung by my daughter.
Thank you, Reverend Shirley. I received all that. I'm going to try to get through this song. It's been a emotional day. Then when he sang this day, and then I see Aaliyah, oh my God. And one of the things she said about being lined up with the divine will of God, and what I get from that is there are so many dreams God has placed in each and every one of us. And through prayer, all of those dreams can and will come true.
Star, for this is my way.
with scars, but still she strode with her last doubts of courage.
Sunrise Silent Prayer Group that we're going to be doing here. And it's taken from Matthew 6, the full chapter, but Matthew 6:6 states, but when you pray, go into your room, and when you shut the door, pray to your Father who is in the secret place. And your Father who sees you in secret will openly reward you. And this prayer group will meet every day at 6:30. To 6:45. We meet via conference call, and we start off with a short meditation and daily inspiration, and we elevate the circle. The facilitator will welcome all people who call in, but no one is to identify themselves, because this is not about personality and who comes that day and who doesn't come that day. The only one that will, you voice you will hear will be that of the facilitator as we go through the first 5 minutes of heightening our consciousness. And then after that, if you have someone you are praying for, whatever their circumstance is, we don't want to know. You just announce their name and enter them into the circle. I don't want to hear about their university hospital. I don't want to hear that their husband left them. I don't want to hear anything about their circumstance. God knows their circumstance. That's none of our business. We pray to see them in the highest light. We pray for the greatest good. That's all we pray for. We don't want to know. We don't identify ourselves in the circle. If you recognize the facilitator's voice, that's your business. Okay? This is pure prayer. This is how the Unity Circle of Prayer started. At 6:40, the facilitator will then begin a prayer, which we call intercessory prayer, praying for the highest good of all concerned. And promptly at 6:45, we close, and everybody goes about their work day, their business. It's all about keeping high consciousness. And if anybody is interested in this, you must first contact me, and I will talk to you. Second, you must read Matthew 6, chapters 1 through 14, and meditate on that, because that describes the perfect way to pray. And after you have meditated on Matthew 6, 1 through 14, if you still feel like you would like to be involved, and if everybody got a pen and paper, if you don't, they're available in the back, and if you're interested, you can call me on my cell number,
It's 216-469-5216. I'll make that available tonight downstairs as we have dinner. There is no attendance requirement. If you don't feel one day like you want to come, you say, oh, I don't feel like getting up, please do not come. It is not an obligation, it is a privilege. You come, you pray at your highest state of consciousness. If you're not in your highest state of consciousness, I love you, we can talk later on, but this is business, this is God's business. So if you want to join in, you may join in silently and pray along. And if, at the moment of entering names into the circle, you can enter yourself in the circle, you can enter someone that you're praying for in the circle, but we do not want to know the circumstance. Okay. You have a question?
Can you say the number again?
My number is 216-469-5216. I've only selected three people right now who will be facilitators. This goes Monday through Saturday. If you come in Monday, don't come in the rest of the week till Saturday. That's fine, because nobody knows who's in the circle. Only three people today or four people. We don't get into all that personality. It's all about praying for the highest good of everyone. So if you're interested in and it'll also lift you up each day. If you're there, if you're not there, but it's all about our consciousness. And I just wanted to do that because of Shirley, you inspired me. I didn't know how I was going to start this off with the group, but surely it's God's will that it would be that way. And I thank you for the emphasis that you placed on prayer. With that, please go ahead.
Thank you. Hold up 1 second with any music. We're going to do the prayer offer our tithes and offerings. Now, because of the fact that this whole situation with the pandemic, we don't pass around a plate. And for that reason, we just ask that you put your love offering in the thank you box. If you have a prayer request, you could do that as well. Put your prayer request in this thank you box, knowing that God answers prayer. Did you put the new prayer box? Okay. And so we are going to say this prayer together. I will say it first and you can repeat after me. It is divine love through me blesses and multiplies.
Divine love through me blesses and multiplies.
All that I am.
All that I am.
All that I have.
All that I have.
All that I give.
All that I give.
And all that I receive.
And all that I receive.
And so it is.
And so it is.
Amen. I'm going to call my daughter up. She is giving us a song for a benediction. And it is Secret Place. Secret Place.
Beautiful sermon today. I loved what you said in the beginning. Sometimes a prayer is simply just sitting in silence. And at that point in time, I believe you've reached your secret place. So we can go ahead and play. Dwelling place. Oh, thank you, God.
Watches over us wherever we are. God is, and so it is. Amen and amen. I thank you for joining us in this service.